Bungalow. We're here till 12 o'clock this morning. Are you lucky people?
Let's explain a little bit more who we are. I'm Dickity Wickity Booga.
Dobbity Dobbity Doo Dah.
Dick Dobbity Dob Dick.
Yes! We did it right! Thank you!
It's gonna be the first time we've ever done it right, and now we're gonna drop that item now we've done it right. Let's meet the Bungalow heads! Nice. Come on! Who's here first? Doorbell? Yes, there we are! It's Chanel!
No, it's not. How was your sleep in the tunnel? So the bungalow.
Yeah, comfy.
It was a very comfy bed.
Yeah.
Where's the bacon, by the way?
Apparently you hate carrots.
Oh, yeah.
Right, what's bad about carrots?
Look at that.
It tastes disgusting.
They're just disgusting.
What are you going to do now?
Eat it.
Is he going to eat them?
Shove them in your face. Go on, grab a couple of sticks.
Raw.
Not one. Hey, look. That. Like this.
Pretend you're a rabbit. Come on.
You're on last place, by the way, so if you eat three of these in a row, then you'll get two.
No, give them all in two. 10.
Five bungalow points.
Five. All right, five. Three carrots. That's one.
One.
Come on, this is good, healthy breakfast,
one.
This.
No, you're not giving it out. Go on,
follow. Oh, she's really not into it. No, just one. Are you going to throw up? No?
Disappointing, would have been good TV. Never mind, well done, well done. Stand there.
Thank you very much, Chanel. Five bungalow points. Well, they're all ready. Hello, Shane.
Hello, Shane.
How are you, mate?
Shane used to be a girl, but now he's 9 years old.
I'm not a girl.
Sorry, I was giving him the wrong note. It's a different show. Shane, you're 9 years old and you're from Lewisham and you hate getting dressed in the morning.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, see that? He's still in your pyjamas.
What do you like about it?
Huh?
This can't be bothered.
What do I like about Jen?
You don't bother anything.
Absolutely nothing to say. It's Cleo. Hello.
Hello. How are you? Where did you get the from?
The shop.
Oh, thanks very much for that one.
1.6 valve turbo injection. You're very accident prone, and one day at school you tripped up about 10 times.
Yeah.
Oh, now look what you've done. You've all over.
Oh, you just spilled the carrots on the floor. Come on, stop it now.
Pick him up for five bungalow points. Pick him up for five bungalow points.
Right, you pick him up.
We'll meet the next person. Pick him up.
It's Jasmine. Hello, Jasmine.
No, listen. Before we went live earlier on,
Okay.
Just burped in his face, didn't you?
Yeah.
Do it again. Go on. You are filthy.
Jasmine,
what are you doing with that spoon?
Well, apparently Jasmine can dance with a spoon stuck on her nose. So let's see the spoon on the nose and dance, please.
Yeah, you can finish.
Oh,
sorry,
hang on. Oh no, hold on, the spoon.
Thank you very much,
Jay. Sorry about that. Just lob the carrots in. Jasmine, okay, go on, dance with the spoon on your nose.
What do you think I'm going to learn how to dance?
You just don't know. Thanks, Jasmine. Okay, and it's Charlie.
Charlie!
How was the gungeon? Oh, no, you didn't get gungeon yesterday. You nearly did, didn't you? But we got it all wrong, and it was actually Chanel.
Let's have a little chat with him.
Okay. Charlie, you're 9 years old from Deptford, and you can look like a monkey if you want to at any given moment.
Charlie!
No,
you're still from Broccoli, sorry. 12 years old and says...
I've just read what it says here. Ugh.
When she looks up, only one eye goes up and the other stays in the same position. You sick person. Can't do it.
Oh no, don't like that.
Go on, no, wait, so new close-up. See that close-up? That's your close-up camera. Oh, man. Are you doing that on purpose or does that just happen naturally?
Happens naturally.
So you're naturally weird. Yes? Oh, I don't like you anymore.
You are strange. The bungalow heads up! Awarding you bungalow points for things you do good. We're taking away for things you do bad. And we're going to have a look at the prizes. Stop it. Third prize, if you come third later on at midday today, Father Christmas could bring you this, which is some war cream. No, it's no egg.
The nasal air clippers and a foreign adapter plug. And also you get this.
Second place.
You
get one of them.
And all that. And you get a nice little...
But if you come first, if you win the bungalow... So that's, isn't that, eh? What about that?
That's amazing. So that's absolutely amazing.
That's amazing.
Right now, you guys can win some more bungalow points in the next game, but we're going to give some contact details. Go and stand there and get a bib around your neck and get yourselves ready.
Scoreboard first. Let's have a look at the points. How they're looking. Yes. In the scoreboard, Chanel has 23, you know.
Yes, and 40 with Shane, you know.
Yes, Cleo, 65, you know.
And you know, Jasmine's got 55.
And you know what? Charlie's got 22.
And Alex has got 80.
Alex is still in the lead. Chanel is losing, so you really need to get some points.
Now, before you get going with this, get yourselves ready, get your bibs around. Oh, you got your bibs around. Yeah. But we're going to tell you how you guys can get in contact with us here. Yes, all you have to do is get in contact with us via the telephone if you want to play some games with us or just chat to us. Yeah, you can just phone up and chat, and we will literally just chat to you on the phone. Right, here's the phone number. I don't know it.
0845 900 2222. 0845 900 2222. Aspiration Dark Air for National Rate Supply. Diddly diddly dee, diddly diddly dee, bat the bat ba ba, diddly diddly dee.
You've got the buddly diddly dee.
Oh, yeah, the buddly diddly dee.
I look at my fingernails, yes.
And if you've got the email, bungalow@bbc.co.uk, bungalow@bbc.co.uk, diddly diddly dee.
Log on!
Stop it!
Right, we're gonna play the game. Log Let's on. Play this!
Just a job. Get your breakfast cereal and stick it in your gob.
Cereal game. Yes, the idea of the game is simple, easy peasy, wheezy cheesy. All you're going to do is eat your cereal as fast as you can. The person with the least cereal in their bowl at the end of the game is the winner of 15 bungalow points. So let's get some time on the clock.
Are you ready?
Time
starts. Not yet.
Not yet.
Now, go on.
You got a minute.
Shove it in your gob.
Oh dear, bit of a problem here. Oh, 8, 7, 6. Oh, 5, 4. Look at Alex.
3, 2, 1.
Sorrow.
I've got to say now.
Yes.
That the boys are a couple of pansies. Look, what you guys are doing, you go naff all.
You like we said, you're supposed to shove it in your gob.
Shove it in your gob.
You still got half a bowl left, so you're no good. Shane, no. Alex, no.
No.
Cleo!
You get all the points.
Only a little bit left.
Well done.
Lovely, well done indeed. 15 bungalow points to you.
No, that was not nice. I'm going to do that 5 bungalow points from you. Here's what's coming up today. What?
Sit.
What? It's so good we're not even going to voice over. Oh, no, all right. Well, we're talking about it then.
Dennis the Menace is
all going very well, that bit, wasn't it? Rigged
the
Ghost. Well, we just...
That's... Well... what's going on?
Yeah. Are we rehearsing?
That's what's on the bungalow this morning. Why are you lot... Did you spit that back out of your bowl?
I'm sorry.
Follow us over here.
Come and watch the program.
The blue-painted man is already waiting for us.
You've got fattened bellies now.
Dom.
Now, I've got a confession to make. Come here. We had a burglary last night in the bungalow, yes? We had a burglary. The burglar came in, saw the state of the TV, thought it was so rubbish, so instead of nicking it, he actually replaced it with a new one. Look at that. It's amazing. Beautiful. Thank you very much to the burglar, and you can come back again next week. You know, at the end of the series, we could live in a mansion. And, by the way, if you guys No. Okay, yeah, we can ask him for a new video next week. By the way, if you email us today, bungalow@bbc.co.uk, you'll win this. It's a really sweet, cute little book called Mighty Fizz Chiller. Look at that. That's good, isn't it? There you go. So it's a bungalow@bbc.co.uk. Email us, and if we read out your emails, you'll win this. Brilliant. All right then, okay, let's start the programme. Oh, the tape's already in there. Let's press play. There you go. If I knew you could. Oh, I've won a Newcon, everyone. Cheer and clap. That wasn't stage at all, was it? No. Dick. Hey, listen now. Chanel, listen. He's got a bit of a problem. We've got a new TV, right, that the burglar put there. He's a bit gobsmacked, right, the TV. Don't fart. Okay, so what I want you to do is to get some tissues and stuff them in his face. If you can get Chanel, only Chanel, if you can get 10 tissues in his mouth, then you get 10 bungalow points.
We did that yesterday.
No, it doesn't matter. It's so good, we can do it again. Are you ready? Go! There's one. He doesn't like this, does he? There's two. There's three. He's gonna gag. Oh, man. Okay, let's just call it five, shall we? But please don't try this at home. Do it at someone else's. No, don't try this at home. God. Oh, my God, God. His spit is all dried up. His mouth has gone all manky. How many is that?
Seven.
Okay, time for the boinky boinky game. Everyone on the feet, come on.
No, bounce up and down. We need to kill Dick, but never mind. Everyone bounce up and down.
It's Paige. Hello, Paige. Hello, Paige.
Paige?
Hello.
How are you? You all right?
Yay! How many bounces do you think Dominic Yukon is going to do on his trumpet today? How many bounces?
Not difficult.
Seven.
Okay. Hey, Paige.
And on the phone, I should have AJ. Hello.
Hello.
AJ, where are you from?
Where?
What?
Mansfield.
Do you know what?
Mansfield. Not Mansfield. No.
All right. But do you know what? Do you know what?
He said Brentwood.
I had a.
Where are you from, mate?
Brentwood.
Oh. Forget the Macclesfield reference.
Mansfield.
Oh, where are you from?
Which one's talking to us now?
Are you from Brentford or Mansfield?
Come
on. Hey?
Mansfield. Where are you from?
Brentford.
Mansfield. Oh,
forget it. How many bounces do you think?
How many bounces
do you think Donald Lucas going to do?
My legs.
How many bounces?
15! So we've got 7 over here with Paige, 15 over right there with AJ. Pick your teams now, Bungalow here.
Go on then, pick your teams. Who's gonna, how many bounces are you gonna do?
15 over there, 7 over here. How many?
7 there,
on.
15. Go! Come on, choose your team. How many bounces? Oh,
thank you, Jasmine. Thank you, Jasmine. I've got
all right
a friend.
Then.
I've got
well,
a friend.
It's over to Dom, you've got to see how many bounces he's gonna do.
Watch those pants bounce.
No, don't
here
look at
goes
the pants.
You were absolutely right on the button, spot on, my dear! Are you not happy about that? Paige?
You win!
Are you still there?
You win.
Paige?
Paige!
Hello?
Ah, oh, there you are! You've won this!
Yay!
Oh, are you happy?
Yeah.
Sounds like it.
Bye!
More boingy boingy next week!
Yeah, come with me, come with me. I love it. Right, listen. Oh, 10 points, by the way, for Jasmine. Yeah, well done, Jasmine. Don't let anyone else know, but I've got a bit of a problem at the moment, yeah. Another Dickie's dilemma. I've got a girlfriend. Have a look at my girlfriend. Here's a picture of her. Yeah, this is my girlfriend. Did you spot something, like, a bit wrong there? Her name's Lisa. Lisa Denton, yeah. And she's got a beard. She's got facial hair. What am I gonna do? Call me now! 0845-900-2222! She's got a beard! 0845-900-2222! Oh, 0845 900-222-222. Ask permission, dial carefully, National Race Apply. Goodbye.
Dom is so small they need to hide chairs at a table.
Where does Tarzan buy his clothes? At a jungle sale!
Jasmine, come out! What have you been doing?
I was hitting this annoying worm.
What's it called?
Turtle's head.
Turtle's head. We've got an annoying worm.
It's not. It's not.
Okay then.
An annoying worm from Mansfield.
Yeah. Preston.
Turtle's head from Mansfield.
Brentford.
Brentwood. Hey, airing cover. Go and explain.
Come here, you little freaks. Because I'm going to go show you something right now. Oh, hello, Moose. How are you today? Oh, lovely. All right, then. Now, look. Inside here is the airing cupboard.
I mean, yeah. We've got no rhythm, no timing.
Hello? Is that mice again?
What?
Those mice!
All right, inside here is the airing cupboard, right? This is where someone every single week goes to air their views. If they got something off their chest, they want to get off their chest, all they do, blah, blah, blah.
Oh, I'm mad. Youth of today. Oh, they rubbish. What do they do? They don't work. What is their purpose in society? They don't earn money. They just take money from their parents, spend money all the time. They listen to rubbish bands like S Club 99 and M&M's. Why don't they listen to a bit of classical, a bit of jazz? They do nothing with it. I'm not finished.
Shut up. You're finished now.
Later.
Deary me.
My
He's
word.
Got a few issues. Hey, guys, he was slagging you guys off. What have you got to say to him?
Well, he's got a few issues, but at least he hasn't got a girlfriend called Lisa Denton with a beard. Right, OK, then. Let's press play.
Apparently, that girlfriend's a PR lady as well.
Yes, she is.
Is she?
Very high.
Very good.
She's going to give us loads of prizes, apparently.
Oh, not anymore, she's not.
I wonder whether she'll give us a fake beard. Right, anyway, Chuckle Brothers, come on, let's have your press play.
Start. There we are. Oh, there it is. Absolute genius. That stuff is absolute genius. What is it?
Genius.
Hey,
Richard News has emailed. He says, "What's happened to your groovy old telly?"
Well, I'll tell you what's happened.
It was nicked.
It wasn't. Well, it's kind of nicked, and then just the burglar replaced it with this. And we got a lovely new shiny telly. Isn't it lovely?
Yeah.
You don't care, do you? You don't give a monkey's.
No. Hey, have a look. What else is on? Press.
Okay. Have you got the remote? Where's the remote? Just press the remote.
No! You've ruined it now. Reset. You've ruined that now! Oh, God.
There it is.
Jimmy Savile and Matthew Kelly have a scrap! I know.
He stuck Jimmy Savile's head in there.
Oh, there's some dropout there. Oh, look at that! Oh, he's kicking him out! I don't believe it!
Oh, Matthew Kelly's not happy
Jimmy
about
jingle,
that.
Jingle jangle! Oh. Yeah.
Stars in their eyes. Oh. Oh, yeah.
I think that's the end. OK, yeah. So now. Once you've stopped, you've got to pop.
But
No, that's wrong. Once you've stopped, you popped. You tell him.
Should we give him a chance for some more Bungalow points?
Yeah, with once you popped, you've got to stop.
Yes. Right, now let's have a look at the scoreboard before we play that ridiculous game. Here it is. This is the state of the scores. Chanel's got 33. Well done, Chanel.
Shane is 40 years old.
And, Leo's got 80 children.
Yeah. Jasmine's got 65 goats.
Charlie lives at number 22 Pembroke Road.
And Alex, 80. Ah, so that's the Bungalow point.
Exactly, well done. Now.
Okay, so Cleo and Alex, you're tied at the top with 80 points each at the moment, so we've got to kind of work out who's going to play this game, because the person at the top and the person at the bottom plays it. So, to play it, you've got to say, we'll start with you, Alex, Rumpelstiltskin backwards. Go on.
See, Rumpelstiltskin
backwards.
We've got
to read it down for you there. Read that backwards. Go on.
No, you can't read it. Go on, Rumpelstiltskin. What is it?
I don't know.
Go on. Read that backwards. Can't do it?
No.
Who else is it?
Right, Cleo.
Read that backwards.
Nix Glitz Del Mum.
Yes!
Yeah! Well done. There we are.
Well done. You got one Bungalow point for that, which makes you've got 81 points now, so you are now in the lead, Alex.
It's Cleo.
Come on, Cleo. Up on your feet.
Cleo and Charlie.
And Charlie, you're at the bottom at the moment, so you're going to play once you've
Cleo
popped.
And Charlie. OK, here's the deal, guys. Now, stand there, smile, stand there, smile and bow. Thank you very much. Well done.
Let's explain the premise of this game. Basically, Cleo, you're at the top. Charlie, you're at the bottom. In this game, if you win, you'll stay at the top. If you lose, you'll go to the bottom. And Charlie will be in the lead.
If you
win... How's about the look at her face?
If you win, then... I'm talking. Hello, look at me. All right. Oh, no, here we go.
Go on.
If you win, then you will get all of her points and you will go to the top. You fancy that? Good. All right, then.
Right, put the big comedy trousers on.
Big comedy trousers.
And explain what you're going to do. You've got 60 seconds in which to get as many balloons into your big pants as possible without popping them. Person who pops a balloon, the game stops, you're the loser, OK? Or the person with the most balloons is the winner. Get it?
Yeah.
OK. Oh, let's just put your things on. Over. Hold on a minute.
Yeah, that's it.
OK, 60 seconds starting now.
Go for it. Go on. Don't pop them. Don't do whatever you do, don't pop them.
Everybody listen carefully for popping balloons. Yeah. If you hear balloons pop, the game is over.
Go on, don't pop any. Whatever you do, don't pop them.
Don't pop the balloons.
Oh, Cleo. No, that was me. No, sorry, carry on. No. Come on, carry on.
Come on, stand over here. Let's try Charlie first. Front, there we are. Oh, we got one. We got two. We got three. We got four. We got five. We got six. We got seven. We got eight. We got nine. We got 10. We got 11. Well done, Charlie.
Do you know what? Cleo over here, we're not even going to bother counting yours because it's blatantly obvious that you have actually won the game because there's absolutely hundreds in there. Well, there's not hundreds, that'd be ridiculous. But you've actually got about 15 in there. There's about 15 balloons in there. Charlie gutted. It was your chance to win all of her points. You didn't get them. You're back to your normal score. And Cleo stays at the top. Clap.
You are still the leader. Well done. Charlie is still the loser. Well done. Okay, well, me and Dom now are going to get on the... Stop it. We're going to get on the sofa and watch Dance of Medicine.
Yes.
You guys have got to pop
all the balloons. Pop all the balloons!
Off you go!
Dear Dick and Dom, I would just like to say that your show is the best. We know that already, but thanks. And that the red suit on the ringmaster looks like the front of a baked beans tin.
Yeah.
Lorna.
Yep.
Lorna, what have you had for breakfast? Silly girl. But we read out your email, so you get one of these books. That's an incentive to email, isn't it? If you want to email us to get one of these books, there you go. All you have to do is create a crazy email and email it to this address.
bungalow@bbc.co.uk. Bungalow heads, repeat it, please.
bungalow@bbc.co.uk.
Easy peasy pudding and pie. We played the balloon game, the pop stop game, just a minute ago, just before Dennis. Cleo won, so she got 10 points. We've added that to the scoreboard, and this is what it looks like at the moment. It's the bungalow points for the bungalow heads, and we're going to have a look that Chanel has got 33.
Well done, Shane has got 40.
Cleo's got 91. I think she's still in the lead.
Jasmine's got 65.
Charlie's got 22.
And 22 for Charlie, you've already said that.
I've already said that.
And 80 for Alex. There you go. I've got to apologise, my microphone wasn't working earlier. It's because I went to the toilet before and I switched my microphone off.
Unplugged.
Who am I talking to? Sorry.
Uh-oh.
There we are.
Yes, time for the Dennis game now. The two people at the bottom of the scoreboard play the Dennis challenge, and that is Chanel and Charlie. Come on, Chanel and Charlie.
Come over here.
Get on your bikes.
To be like Dennis and Menace, you guys got to dress up in these ridiculous Dennis and Menace outfits and the Scouser wigs.
Stick that over your top.
Work it on your head.
Come on.
Come on.
Chop, chop.
We haven't got a date. This is a TV program, you know.
Come on.
Oh, hurry up!
Oh, Charlie,
whack it on your head.
Whack that on your bonnet.
That's right.
Come on, your bonnet. Stand by your bonnet. Don't sit on your bonnet. Last week I busted this game because if you touch the pedals before it all starts, you have to try and reset, and we don't know how to do that, so don't touch it, okay? Well, the idea of the game is you've got 1 minute in which to pedal as far pedal as far as you can. We have the milometers here; they're going to tell us how far you've gone. What you're going to do is pedal for your life, pretend someone that is really menacing you is after you. Just pedal as fast as you can in 60 seconds. So, okay, you can get on your bikes now, but don't touch the pedals.
You've done a lot of talking, mate. That's really good.
My one is. Okay.
The person that wins this, the person that goes the farthest, will win 20 bungalow points, which is all to play for, and your time starts... Now, go! Pedal, pedal! Pedal!
Go on, hurry up!
Faster,
go
on!
No, you can't. You can't know
What have you done, mate?
Go!
Don't
go!
Pedaling
no, you're backwards, you weirdo!
Forward! So far.
1.08 a mile so far.
2.5 here. Yeah, brilliant. Yeah, you're doing well there, Chanel.
No, they keep changing.
Come on, Charlie. Pedal faster than that.
Go on, Charlie.
Charlie, you're pedaling backwards again. Stop it.
Pedal, 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 pedal,
pedal.
Oh, Charlie.
Chanel's doing well there. She's got, like, how far have you gone? You've gone 0.05. And you've gone 1.9. And Charlie's well behind at the moment, and
Charlie, Chanel, just pedal.
It looks like
that.
I reckon Chanel might get this to pip to the post. And how much time we've got left? 25 seconds.
Come on.
3, 2, 1. Stop
what you're doing. Guys, you did pretty good, but Charlie, you were actually rubbish. I should take all that.
You
all
don't
back.
Pedal a bicycle backwards, do you?
Well, he does.
And, it's like a car in reverse.
And well done to you, Chanel. You win the 20 bungalow points!
Yay!
Okay, sit back down there. Watch me tell you what's on the rest of the
week. Hold on. The thing is, right, when we tell you what's on, we always speak all over it, but we love the music, don't we, that's played during this piece.
Yeah,
so we're just going to let you listen to it, and you can see what's on. Have a look. Give it a cup of tea.
He's having a quick cup
of tea. Chuck a Vision, Looney Tunes, and Renter Ghost all to come in a bungalow.
It's all here for you right now. Oh dear. Oh, hang on. Just going to nip to the toilet.
What do you call a lion with toothache? Rory!
Charlie, stop it! Stop it! Come here! Close the door after you, it stinks in there. Hang on a minute. Charlie, what were you doing? I know, it was a bit full on. Like, you know, most people give it a little bonk on the head, but that was just ridiculous. You've killed it. That's not very nice. I'm gonna have to go in there and give it mouth-to-mouth resuscitation now. How would you like to do that to a turtle's head? It's not very nice, is it? Never mind, we'll give you 5 points for being very funny and smacking the turtle's head really hard. Nice one. Right now, it's time to get the comedy mallet and use it for something very different. It's time for the celebrity auction. Yes, the celebrity auction. Can we have a celebrity auction here? Please welcome Tom, Dick and Harry.
All right, darling. No, don't get too close now, will you? You don't get too close, because you might, my hat might fall off my head. Do you know what I mean? Hello there. Now, what's this, by the way? I think this is for later. It's a BBC costume. I don't think that's for this part of the show.
Never mind, we'll just go for
that. Oh, no, it is. It's one of the forfeits, which we're going to explain now. This is the forfeit auction. Hello and welcome, ladies and jelly spoons, boys and twirls. This is the part of the show where you can stitch up your mates by buying a forfeit for them with your hard-earned bungalow points.
Do you understand a word he's just said?
No.
Shall I explain it to you?
Yeah.
All right, come and sit over here. Basically, you guys have got lots of bungalow points, right? And you can give away your bungalow points, yeah? And buy some really good auctions. Louis doesn't like this. Okay, and then, like, get some really good pranks to play on your mates, yeah? But you actually buy them with your bungalow points. Is that good?
Yeah.
Oh, very well explained, Mr. Dominic. We're very well explained.
Sorry, they're
let's
they're
start
a bit
off with lot 104. Lot 104.
Lot 104, ladies and gentlemen.
Lot 104.
Lot 104. Very simple. All you have to do to buy this with lots of hard-earned bungalow points. And the forfeit is you can get a friend to sit with their feet in buckets of custard for the rest of the show. How do you fancy that? Look at them, real buckets of custard. Don't get too close.
So let's start the bidding. Do I hear two bungalow points? Let's start off on two. We got two from Chanel, three from Alex, four from Charlie, five from Lisa, six from Shane, seven from Cleo. Anyone going higher than seven from Cleo?
Who's
going
to give away more than seven bungalow points? Come on, it's a good prank. You can choose anyone.
We need higher than seven. We got seven of Cleo. Anyone going over eight?
Seven.
Come on, somebody's got to put their hand up.
Seven. Come on.
Otherwise, my head's going to explode. Come on, Cleo. Cleo's got seven.
Who's going to give away more bungalow points for that? That's a good one.
Okay, we're still on seven. Anybody go higher than seven? Come on, somebody's gonna go higher than seven. Two buckets of custard, your feet are gonna get stinky and smelly.
Rich, they're not doing it. Sell it. Smack the mallet.
Sold.
Here you go. Well done, Cleo. You bought this. Who do you want to sit with their feet in bucket of custard for the rest of the show?
Shane.
Shane, all right, get your feet off. Go on, get your feet off. Sit down there. Get your feet off and roll up your trousers. You might have Billy Bongo. You sat on Billy Bongo, not Ali Bongo. That's silly. Go on. Oh, no, you're going to stand in the bucket. You're not going to sit. OK, in fact, we're going to stand you in the corner right here next to poor granddad Dom. There you go. Roll up your trouser legs. And this is real. Look, have a look at that. Real custard. There you go. Come on, hurry up, kid. Yeah, in fact, that's pretty good. And because you're facing that way, you have to stand and face the corner for the rest of the show as well.
Just for good luck, Dom, put a little bit on his face as well. Go on.
No, don't fall over. Face the camera.
Yeah. Oh! Right, let's continue with the forfeit auction. It's time for lot 103, ladies and gents, poos, boys and trolls. Lot 103. What's lot 103, Mr. Dominic Woods?
Lot 103. You will have to dress as a bumblebee for the rest of the entire show. And you can only see Buzz. We were going to have a frog, but unfortunately the frog hopped off. OK? So...
What do you want? Shane's got his hand up. What?
Can I still bid?
Yeah, you can still bid with custard on your face. In fact, if you want to bid, you've got to have even more custard on your face. There you go, mate. There you go. Have some on your hair. There you go. Good boy.
Right, let's start the bidding for the bee costume. You have to say Buzz for the rest of the show. Do I hear?
You're going
to
start this off. Get her back.
Five bungalow points. We've got five bungalow points.
Shane's getting
it.
Shane's going.
Clear's going for eight. Anyone going either way? It's a really funny costume. It's a good buzzword. It's a funny costume. Shane's on nine. Clear's on ten. Anyone going either way? Shane's
really doing it. He wants to get his lane back on Shane.
Clear's still going to have the points on 12. Shane's back to 13. Cleo on 14. Shane's gone out the bidding. Cleo's on 14. Shane, you're going down the
aisle. Shane, go on, yeah.
Any higher than 14, Shane? No, it is sold twice, once, three times for Cleo, four times.
Cleo, you're being a bit fancy free with your bungalow points, aren't you, love? What do you want to do with this lot?
Put it on Charlie.
You're going to give it. You don't like boys, do you?
Boys are really losing.
You really don't like boys. So, do you want a bit of custard on his face as well?
No,
that's not part of it. Here we go. Here we are. There's the bee outfit. You will get changed into that later on.
Let's start getting him into
that. Come over here. We're going to get you changed into that.
Charlie, get your trousers on, because that'll be. This is going to be funny. He's going to be a bee for the rest of the show.
Crazy.
Do you remember when we were mugged for the very shirts off our own back?
I do. I remember when our toenail clippings would have been priceless to any one of our adoring, screaming fans.
Oh, yes. Our fans, lovey-dovey.
Oh. Hey, do you remember our number one fan? Yes, she especially loved me. She used to go to all of my gigs. Yes, she used to serenade me with chocolates and flowers and food and drink. And she used to say that I was the best-looking man in the world. Of course, I remember a lovey. Who'd forget? It was your mother. Well, it's true.
I know, lovey.
Oh, yes, everyone used to know who we were. We used to have loads of fans, and now all we have... are these fans. Hey, people may have forgotten who we were, but we haven't forgotten, have we, Lovey?
No, Lovey. Strike up the band!
We're Diddy Dick and Dom, welcome to our cupboard. We've lived here all our lives and never been discovered. We might be really small, but we've both got big hearts. It's all right in here, so long as no one... There's no room to swing a cat, a barely room to hang your hat, but there's no need to push and shove, because we got cupboard love.
Oh, Lovey, Ariel's my only remaining fan. Wow!
Yeah.
he's gonna be funny in that costume, but I'm sure, like, did somebody hear some mice?
Get on with it!
Time for Dickie's dilemmas now. Between me and you, though, this, remember? Phone's already. For some reason, it's not plugged in, but I'm sure we'll get some callers. I told you earlier that my girlfriend's got a bit of a problem. Have a look at her and see if you understand what the problem is. Yes.
What's her name?
Her name's Lisa Denton.
Lisa Denton?
Lisa Denton. Yes, very nice, Lisa. Have another look. Think again. Have another look. What do you think the problem is?
She's got a beard! Facial hair! What am I gonna do? You can't kiss a girl with facial hair!
Quiet, quiet, please. Only between me and you. Oh, the phone's ringing! Is it gonna work? Hello, who's there? Anyone there?
Hello.
Yeah. Who is it?
Hello?
Hello? What's your name?
Danielle.
Danielle. Hello, Danielle. Right, just between me and you now. My girlfriend's got facial hair. What am I gonna do? Can't kiss her, you know. Gets great, it's great on the old chin when you kiss her. Come on, tell me, what am I gonna do?
When she's sleeping, I think you should wax the face.
I like that. I like that a lot. I'm gonna give you for that 8 out of 10, Danielle. Great. Be it off, like it. Right, put the phone down. Thank you, Danielle. Hello? Who's there?
Natasha.
Now, I've got a bearded woman. What am I gonna do with her?
Tell her that you don't want to hang around with her because she's embarrassing. She looks like I really hate you.
But she's my girlfriend.
Tell her she's ugly.
Thank you so much. Goodbye. 9 out of 10, though, there. We'll see if anybody's got any better dilemmas a little bit later on. Thank you so much. Oh, Dom. What, oh, is he nearly in it?
Yeah. I'll tell you what. If you can, he's nearly in there. Go on, stick your feet through there. Go on, take off your shoes. Oh, no, don't bother taking off your shoes. No, take off your shoes. No, don't bother. Take off your shoes.
What should I do?
Oh, forget it. Look,
let's just go.
Come over here. Come on, Captain Pat. Come over here. Yep, let's just have a good look. Here's the area cabin. If you've got some things you want to get off your chest, like some hairs, whatever, all you have to do is come into the area cabin, air your views, and today it's this man here.
Oh, I'm so mad I could spit! Kids nowadays, oh, they want to be older than they actually are. They're caked in makeup. You see 2-year-olds wandering around caked in makeup. They've all got piercings, they've got nose rings, earrings, belly button rings. Walking down the street.
One of them?
Exactly! Whoa! One of those, and then walking down the street, they have fridges flying at them. And they all want to be famous.
Wait a minute. Have you got kids?
No.
What are you going to do when you have kids? How are you going to bring them
up? I'm not having kids. Look at them. Evil little children. Get away from me.
Shut your face. All right, then. Let's go over here and see how our busy little bee's getting on.
You put that
busy
bee. No, hold on a minute. You can't say, oh, I don't like this. You've got to speak buzz language from now on.
You've got to go buzz.
Buzz, Charlie. You can't say anything else but buzz. You're a bee.
No, hang on a minute. This is going to be a scouser bee. Go on, oi.
Charlie, right, let's see.
You go around nicking other people's honey.
Scouser bee. Right, Charlie, how old are you?
No!
You're a bee! Oh. Bees don't talk! How old are you?
Hey, listen, are you annoyed with him? Do you want to stop doing this, yeah? Yeah? No. Do you want to stop doing it, yes?
No.
Yes?
Say something.
Do you want to stop doing this?
Buzz.
Now, here's what I really want. Come over here, do a little dance for us. Come on. Can we have some comedy music, please, Sam? Yeah. Here we are.
Look at him!
Oh, do a little dance. Come on, do a little comedy dance. Come on, go on. Come on. Hey! Buzz, I go buzz, go buzz. Buzz. Hey, on there. Hey! Buzz. Hit the bee. Dance. There you go, dance. There you are, sit up. Poor little guy. Poor little Charlie. Poor little bee.
You've been forfeited, mate, I'm afraid. Anyway, we're going to have a look at the scoreboard. And no, we're not going to have a look at the scoreboard. We're going to have a look at the prize. Third prize. If you come third at midday today, you could be winning this. A nose clipper. Actually, my girlfriend could use that a bit. And also a plug adapter.
If you come second right here in the bungalow, you win these two really famous prizes. They are one of them and one of them.
That and that.
There we are, sorry about that.
But, if you come first, you get this. That's that. TV and video combi.
TV and video combi.
Pinball machine.
Pinball machine.
Pinball machine. Angel with no head.
Angel with no. Beg your pardon.
It's a karaoke machine, not a pinball machine.
Should we have a look at the scoreboard? This is the scoreboard, and this is how everyone's looking right here in the bungalow today.
I thought we'd already looked at it.
It's been a massive link, isn't it?
We've already looked at it. Okay. Shane's got 53.
Shane's got 40.
Cleo's got 70.
And moving on, Jasmine's got 65.
Charlie's still at the bottom with 27. Sorry,
Alex,
Charlie.
Alex has got 80. Come on. Charlie, listen, you're last, mate. Yeah, as if you're not humiliated enough, all right? Do you feel quite silly? Yeah? What we're going to make you do now is the pants dance. So now, just for the bee, we're going to go and get some pants. We're going to get some pants from here. What colour do we want? Some pants. Yeah.
Do you like that one?
You've got to wave this around as well.
Do you like the gag, by the way? You missed it.
Pots and pants.
You went to the kitchen.
Yes, yeah.
And I said, yeah, some pots and pants.
Shut up.
Right, put the pants on your head. Right, you got them on your head. No, you've got to have lots of pants on your head.
Come on.
There we are. Right. And we're going to put you into the middle of the room, Charlie. And now, please welcome a drum roll, please. Drum roll, please. Drum roll, please.
Bad man.
Right, put those back on your head. You'll lose points if you do this, you know. Oh, do it all wrong. Do it right and you'll keep your points.
Come on,
that'll do, dog.
Big brave boy.
Take your stage.
Right now, ladies and gentlemen, Spoons, introducing to you, doing the brand stats, what a Wally, it's Charlie!
Buzz, buzz, buzz.
Come on, dance!
Yeah, yeah, baby, look at me!
Charlie, how did you feel about that?
Listen, Charlie, how would you feel if we gave you some bungalow points? Would you like 20 bungalow points?
Yes.
Well, you can't have any. We'll give you 10, though. 10's quite... No, don't say yes, you say buzz.
Buzz.
No, 10 bungalow points, otherwise you might cry. There you go, Fanta. How are you doing over there? How's the bucket of custard? Give me some on the face, it's all dried off. Go on.
That's better.
Go on!
Come on, I can't even put it in the machine. I've got so much.
Yeah, hey, I'll do it. Where is it? Oh, no, it's only in the machine.
It's all right.
Press play.
It's our heroes.
What's going on in here? Plans. I have no idea.
Hello, everybody. My name is Reverend Down.
And I'm Reverend Up.
Yes, and we are here to give our special tribute to the Chucker Brothers. They are our comedy heroes.
So let me repeat our names. This is Rev Down, and I'm Rev Up.
Yeah, and this is the Chucker Brothers shrine here that we've made. There they are.
They've Paul actually and Barry appeared. Chuckle.
Say
they've
hello.
They've appeared to
there
us.
There they are, look. Oh, there Paul and Barry.
They are so in awe today, yes. They are not speaking to us, because we are not worthy.
We're making it a bit like Christmas. The bungalow heads are going to bring them presents from afar. So let's start off.
Yes. They are offerings.
Let's start off with Cleo. Would you like to come and stand
Hello, my child.
Hello,
How
my
are
child.
You?
Come and stand
How
in,
are you today?
Kneel in front of the Chucker Good. Brothers. Always kneel in front of them. That's it.
And you must do the Chucker Brothers salute, which is...
No, salute them. Salute them properly. That's it. What are you offering the Chucker Brothers, my child?
Old and dried out flowers.
I bet you
know. Old and dried out flowers.
Why?
Because I think their house is about... That sort of
Thank you, my child.
Stuff.
But that's very Thank kind. You. See you later.
Goodbye.
anyway.
Shut up.
Not for you, for me.
Dried up flowers. Chucker Brothers. Hold on, what?
To you. You know, when you give it to them, you must say Chanel. From me to you.
Chanel, my child, kneel in front of the Chucker
and
Brothers.
And do this.
They're our heroes, remember. They're our heroes. That's it. Right, now turn around, my child. And tell us what you're offering.
What are you offering the Chucker Brothers?
Half of a Twix.
Oh. It's got hairs on it.
Half of Ian Twix.
Half of a hairy Twix.
That's so generous. You probably won't eat for days and days, but it doesn't matter now, because, Chanel, that is for the chocolates. And we'd like you to offer it
from me. Offer it from me to you. Turn round. From me. From me.
From me to you, my child.
From me.
From me to you.
From me to you.
Oh, she can't do it.
Oh, and by the way, Chanel, lovely tash. Goodbye. Thank you, my child. The child has been overcome by them. She's too overcome. Okay. No. This is Charlie.
Charlie.
He's a big beast.
Charlie, one with nature. You're one of nature's greatest gifts to us.
Charlie, kneel in front of the Chucker Brothers now. You're here.
And you and
salute
you must
them. Charlie, what are you offering them, my child?
Jam.
But no, Buzz. Just
what?
Buzz.
No, Buzz.
No, you Buzz.
Buzz. You see earlier, Charlie's was dressed as a bee earlier, and he can only speak in Buzz language. He can't speak English.
So what anymore. Are you giving them?
Buzz.
Why?
And now what he wants to do is just say from me to you.
Buzz.
Oh. Off you fly. Oh, off you fly, my child.
Let's offer the Chucker Brothers the jam sandwiches. Who's next? Shane! Oh, Shane's in the custard, hold on. Right, let's help him along.
Okay, walk in the custard. Ready?
Walk the custard.
Go, ready?
What's going on? What is going on here?
Right. Shane's in the custard. Right. Oh, I'm connected to my button's got stuck round your...
I'm going to have to stay here, my child.
Could you... Oh, hold on a minute. You salute the Chucker Brothers.
Here we are.
Give them the salute.
Connected.
Right, come on, give it... Salute them.
Salute the Chucker Brothers by going...
Right, what are you offering them, my child?
Two dead spider skin and
to turn him around.
A slug and a dead moth.
What? Why?
Because the other day, in one of their episodes, they were trying to kill a woodworm. Watch out, there's a slug in there.
There we are. There you are, Paul and Barry. That's your offering.
And I'll say from me to you.
From me to you. And,
off you go. Okay. Who's next? Okay. Oh, right. Off you go. Okay. Chanel, salute the Chuckle Brothers.
Salute them. Say on bend the knee.
Do it.
That's Jasmine.
What are you offering them?
I'm offering
a what?
A cola can
squashed
that's
up.
Been squashed. How did it get squashed, my child?
Oh, somebody stepped on it.
That's bad, but it was meant to be.
Say from me to you.
From me to you.
Oh, and just give it to the... Right.
Oh. Thank you. And finally,
lastly.
Alex is here to offer... Salute the Chucker Brothers, my child.
Can you tell... And now, what do you offer the Chucker Brothers, my child?
A lock of hair.
Whose hair is it?
Whose hair is it?
My cousin's.
Your cousin's hair. Why are you cutting your cousin's hair off?
I wasn't.
So there we are. That has been our tribute to the Chucker Brothers.
And next, Sweet Face.
You.
Sweet Face. The
stinky
sweet face.
Can I cut this off?
Wait, no, not yet. Don't come back to us yet. Right, we're ready. Okay, we're ready.
Sweet race.
Right, wait, hang on.
Wait,
can we take
this off?
Okay. What on earth was all that about? Sweet Face Challenge. Right, guys, get on your feet. Come over for the Sweet Face Challenge. Where are the sweets? Here they are. Let's clean up a little bit and do the Sweet Face Challenge. That's yours.
And there you go. Very, very simple. Here are the rules. The top of the leaderboard is...
Alex.
Alex, well done. You're top of the leaderboard at the moment. Who would you like to play Sweet Face against?
You can choose any of the Bungalow Heads or me or Dom.
Anyone.
Shane!
Shane! Excellent!
Right, okay, hold on. Let's get the T-shirt. Let's bring him round here.
Go on.
Shane, okay. Come on, mate. Right, here we go. Oh, there we are.
Yeah.
Right. Oh dear, oh dear.
Right, you go. There we go. Okay, are you ready, Shane? All you're going to do is you're going to lick the sweets and stick them to your face. The one with the most sweets stuck to the face at the end, get 20 Bungalow points. And your time starts now! Go! Lick it to your face, stick it to your face. Lick him, Three, two, one, stop!
Yay! Right. Starting off with Alex, we got one and that...
They just fell off.
Oh, two.
You got two.
Two.
And they did, I can confirm, but when the collection went off, he did actually have four sweets starting to hit his face.
Alex is the winner!
No, that's
Shane's
Alex.
Shane's the win.
Sorry! Sorry, Shane is the winner!
Oh, he did used to be a girl, but there we are.
Custom boy wins!
Custom boy, well done, you get 20 Bungalow points!
You can eat that if you want, yes. 20 Bungalow points, very well done.
You're watching Dick and Dom in the Bungalow.
Yes, thank you.
Oi, what do you call a man without a spade on his head? Douglas! Come on then!
Alex, what have you been doing?
You've been hitting
turtle's head. Yeah, I've been hitting a turtle on his head because he's saying rubbish jokes.
He's saying rubbish jokes, are they that bad?
Right, everybody line up in a row, because now you're going to do your scary faces for us. Line up in a row, because it's time to play.
You'd better watch out, they're a gruesome crew. Get them first or they'll get you.
They're the Bungalow Bogeyman.
I've got Bungalow Bogeyman. And the way to play is do a scary face and then we'll pick who's got the scariest face
in
to play.
In line.
Go, Jasmine. Get in line so we can see you. That's it. Okay,
put your scariest face. Go, scary face.
Charlie, scary.
Put a scary face.
Buzz.
Yeah, hello. That was pretty disgusting.
Scary.
Oh, that's
scary.
No, he doesn't want to play.
Right, we've decided.
Chanel, I think.
And Shane.
Chanel and Shane.
So, Chanel.
Come over here.
Help me.
Shane, you take that bucket.
Hold on a minute.
You take the other one.
Walk. Okay. There we are, mate. Yeah. Right, Bungalow Bogeyman. Basically, the idea of the game is you've got 60 seconds in which to throw as many balls as possible that will stick onto the Rent-A-Ghost characters because Rent-A-Ghost is next.
And by the way, if you have just tuned in and wonder why Shane has got her buckets in the feet custard, then earlier on we had the forfeit auction. I can't remember who it was. Cleo actually gave away some Bungalow points to buy the forfeit of Shane standing with feet and bucket of custard. Blah, 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 blah.
For the whole show. Until midday. He's got another hour in there. Enjoy, mate. Okay, 60 seconds on the clock.
Starting now!
Oh, you've got one on Dobbin!
Go in! Get Dobbin!
That means you've already earned 5 extra Bungalow points there.
Oh, there it
is! Well done! Oh, no!
Oh, dear. I think Paul Dobbin's lost his body.
Keep throwing them, come on, keep throwing them.
Come on!
Stick them. There's 15
seconds left
for the person that gets the most balls on.
20.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Stop it.
That was Bungalow Bogeyman. And how did Paul Chuckle get in there?
I got two on the donkey.
Come back here. Oh, you poor.
I got two on the donkey.
You poor Chuckle. Oh, no! Where's your hand gone?
Get on with it. Come
all right.
On.
What, you're trying to give me a haircut?
Right, okay, now, Shane, shut up, everyone. Okay, let's count.
Two on the donkey.
Let's count Shane's.
The white one, Shane. One, two, three. Sorry about this. Five, four, five, six, seven.
And you got the ones on Dobbin first, so that means you get 5 bungalow points already, Shane. Chanel, you got the black balls. You got 1, 2, 3.
So Shane is the winner.
Well done. 20 bungalow points in all. Well done, my sir.
Yes. Well done. Well done. Fantastic job.
No.
Fantastic job.
Take the other hand.
Lovely job. Well done.
Okay. And now, since we've seen the Rent-A-Go characters on the game, why don't we watch the show? Come on, we'll get it on the video down here. Let's get Paul Chucker without a head and Barry with legs to watch as well. Barry's legs and Paul Chucker with no head. You all watch.
Go sit down, everyone. Come on, you bunch of freaks. Come
on. It's time for Rent-A-Go. Come on, press play.
There it is.
What a mad show this is.
Oh, really, man.
Look what I just found behind the television during Rent-A-Ghost.
The hairy twigs.
Right. Love a bit of Rent-A-Ghost, don't we, on a Sunday morning?
Ah, yes.
How did you feel about Rent-A-Ghost, Charlie?
Buzz.
Yes, in the forfeit auction earlier, Charlie was made to dress as a bee and speak in a buzz language.
And Shane over there was made to stand in a bucket of custard.
No!
And what?
No.
What?
The joke's wearing thin, dog, the joke,
no, no, I've got to admit, you know, we've done it a few times. We've put custard on your head a few times today. The joke's really wearing thin, isn't it? Would you agree? Huh? Would you agree that the joke of putting custard on your head is wearing thin?
Yeah.
Yes. Do you not find it funny anymore?
No.
You find it very unfunny. Well, we still find it funny! There you go.
Come on, have a look at your reach. This is the Erin Cupboard. Every Sunday morning, we have someone in here who has a problem with something. They want to rant or rave. Let's have another listen.
The kids. Oh, there you are. And the kids smell of cabbage, and they can't go anywhere without mobile phones. Mobile phones stuck to their ear. They sleep with mobile phones, and they like all want to be famous. They want to be the next Gareth Gates or Britney Spears. They can't be famous. They can't sing. They can't dance. Oi!
When we close the door, you're supposed to be quiet.
Oh. Right. I'm not finished. They all want to be famous. They want to be Gareth.
Thank you, we'll be back with you later. Right, time for bad or bad, everyone. Everyone over to the badometer. Come on, over here, because we're going to work out whether something is bad or bad. Now, some people say things are bad.
Just gonna give
oh, look at Shane, he's trying to
go. Shane, pants, well done, mate.
Yeah,
hang on a minute, that was really good. 15 bungalow points for Shane, that was pretty impressive.
You could say that was really good.
Do you want to wipe the custard off?
You could say it was really good, or you could say it was really bad. Because lots of people call bad things bad, and good things bad, and bad things good, and good things bad. Come over here, let's do bad or bad. Right, this is the badometer. We're going to decide firstly whether Leo and Stitch, the new Disney movie, is bad or bad. Let's have a look at a bit of it first.
Hey, that's not Simba.
His name is Stitch.
Oh, great! He's loose!
He's taken a police cruiser!
Yeah, he took the red one.
That crazy trog is about to make a jump!
Where is he?
A place called Hawaii.
So is it bad? Or is it bad? Or is it bad? Is it bad or bad?
Was it bad?
Bad, 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 bad.
Firstly, we'll ask Charlie, was that bad or bad? No!
No!
Buzz!
Buzz!
But that's... Everybody else, bad or bad?
Bad.
Leo and Stitch, the new Disney movie.
Bad,
bad, bad, bad, bad,
bad,
bad, bad, bad, bad, bad, bad, bad, bad, bad, bad, bad, bad, bad, bad, bad,
bad, bad, bad, bad, bad, bad,
bad, bad, bad, bad, bad, bad, secondly, Will and Garrett duetting together on the long and winding road will probably be number one on Sunday. I wonder what Lennon McCartney would think about that.
Long and winding road.
Let's have a listen to it.
Don't leave me waiting here. Lead me to your door. Oh, no.
Shut up!
Yeah,
shut up!
Shut up!
Shut up!
The long and winding road.
Yes, the long and winding road.
Will and Gareth, bad or bad?
Bad or bad?
Bad or bad?
I know we're going to get complaints from all you Gareth fans out there, but come on, if you go out to the shops and you buy the original, right, of Lennon and McCartney singing that song by the Beatles, you'll listen to magic.
You sound like an old man.
It's true, though.
You sound like my father.
You look like an old man. Look at you.
Anyway, OK, now you can hear him in the background. Listen, everyone. Michael Jackson, yes, the king of pop, some people say. But what about his face?
What about his face?
When he first started, he looked like that.
Oh, sweet cherub.
Hold on. Now, he looks like this. Yeah! What is that all about? Hey? Is his face bad or bad?
Bad.
Oh, it's the video phone.
Video phone.
Who could it be?
There's somebody at the door.
There's somebody at the door.
Dick.
Yeah? No, it's Dom. Yes, Dom.
Can you come and let me in? Is that Hannah? I'm gonna come around for a cup of tea.
Is that Hannah from Mesco 7? Is that you?
Yeah,
it is. Oh.
Hello.
Yeah, Hannah.
Hannah.
Do you know what? You're gorgeous. I'd love to snog you. But you can't come in because we don't let celebrities in here. Bye!
Stop it. Stop it! That told her then, didn't it? No celebrities are allowed here, okay?
Sorry, I don't care how gorgeous you are.
If you're a celebrity, you're not coming in, all right? It's loony, this place today, isn't it? Do you like that? What? It's loony today in here, isn't it?
What? Wait, you're looking at it?
Because now.
Oh! That's all, folks, and it nearly is at the end of the show, folks. Thank you very much for that word. Very difficult word as well. Nearly the end of the show, but we've got a few things left. Hang on, just flick the channel a minute as you see what else is on TV. What's it? Oh, what's this? Is this one of those CCTV that... Oh, it's me and Rick. Oh, that's gotta hurt. Look, that's not very nice, is it? Don's beating up. No, I think it's all over. They pull him back, so give him a beat downstairs. Look at that. Dick really has beaten Dom in bad, yeah, there, isn't he? Oh, yeah, kick on the bar, man, and smack in the back, and he's kicking him down the stairs. That's not very nice. Oh, dear, and he's falling over himself. And they're both in a bit of trouble. Oh, dear, that's not very nice, isn't it? I thought they were best of friends as well. Oh, well, do you think they're best of friends? Did you ever think that they were?
We never fight, do we, Diddy? And we never fight. No, we very rarely scrap. I mean, we live our lives in complete harmony. Absolute bliss. I mean, we get on so well, anyone would think we were married. Yes, I mean, I think it's safe to say that we almost never fight.
What do you mean we almost never fight?
Well, we rarely fight.
Well, what do you mean we rarely fight? We never fight.
Yes, we do.
No, we don't.
Yes, we do. What are we doing now?
Well, if you think you're having an argument, then you're wrong.
Well, oh, you're so tiring.
No, you're so tiring.
No!
Do you hear something coming from that cupboard? You didn't hear anything, you got custard in your ear. Okay, now this is the part of the show where we're gonna try and break a world record right here in Dick and Dom in the Bungalow. And here he is. Without any further ado, we please welcome the world dickled breaker, it's Dickie McCord! What are you doing? What are you doing?
Right.
What's that? What's that?
Pants.
No, that.
Oh, that's that.
Very.
Explain my world record attempt.
Okay, now Dickie in a minute is going to attempt the world record for putting on a pair of pants and taking them off the most amount of times in a minute. It's pretty difficult, as you'll see. First of all, let's have a look at a clip of what happens.
Nous arrivons à 15.
Caught it 27 times in 1 minute. Will he beat it? Dickie, how are you feeling?
I'm ready.
Are you mullered?
I'm mullered.
All right, then. Well, to help us through this, adjudicate your extraordinary. It's nearly the end of the show. My mouth doesn't work. Spent a fortune in my nose. Now my mouth doesn't work. Please welcome from the Guinness World Records, Sue! Oh. How do you How did you do that? That was absolutely amazing. Yeah, hello, Sue. How are you? Lovely to see you again.
Hello.
I'm going to give her a kiss on each cheek. Hello.
Oh. Mm-hmm.
I'm going to give her another couple of kisses on each cheek. I'm going to do it again. Watch it. No, I'm not going to do it anymore. Sorry. Right, okay. Current record is?
It's 27. You've got to jump all the way in, all the way up to the top. One continual movement. It's very dangerous.
Who was the world record held by?
Mathieu Baumier from France.
Mathieu Baumier from France.
Mm. Mathieu Baumier. Right.
Okay.
Okay, I'll get the pants
off. Well, he's got his pair of black pants ready.
Yes.
He's equipped. A bit of mood lighting, please. Okay, are you ready? Have you got a minute on the clock?
We've got the clock.
Sue?
Five.
Dickie?
Four, three, two, one.
Six, he's doing pretty well. Seven! Go on, he's really got momentum going now. Seven, go on, Richie! Go on, Richie! Go on, Rich! Go on! Go on, Richie! Go on, Rich! You can do it! 20 seconds to go, come on, mate! Go on, mate, you can do it! At the end, how many did he do?
I counted 17. Did I count 17?
17?
Yep.
Now, it's not a world record, but is that pretty good?
I think we could be looking at the new British record here.
Do you think so? What is the British record?
There isn't one.
So, is he a British record breaker? Dickie McCoskey is a record breaker! Oh, yeah. Oh. Clap! Hey. Well done. How do you feel?
Panted out.
Well, thank you very much, Sue. You go through the bearded coat. Give her a big round of applause. Go on. Go on, big round of applause.
I'm a British record holder.
Well, hang on a minute.
Yes?
It's the beginning of the end of the show!
You're a British record.
British record breaker. Yes, the beginning of the end of the show. Everybody line, we're going to find out who the loser is firstly. Come on, in a line, let's see.
Next to Shane, next to Shane. Get all lined up here. Here.
Too far, because
there we go. Come on, everyone line up.
We'll lower the lights, we'll go along the line, we'll find out who the winner is. Here we go. Who's it going to be?
Is
it going to be Shane, the custard guy? Is it going to be Alex?
Who is going to get guns in the bosses for toilets?
Is it going to be
Cleo? Who's it going to be?
Is it Charlie?
Who's it going to be?
Is it going to be you?
Who's it going to be?
Who's it going to be?
It's
Charlie!
Charlie! Yes, you look mighty happy about it. Are you happy about big guns? Good, okay. Well, I'll tell you what we're going to do. We're going to get you, mate. We're going to scoot you off to the toilet. Are you feeling nervous about this? Buzz? Go, there we go. And get changed whilst you're in there. Get changed and get yourself strapped
while in. While I'm sorting that out.
Get yourself ready. There you go.
Anyone in the bungalow, while one of the programmes is on, one of the shows is on, the girls here put together a little routine for us, a little number. And we've got to show you it before we go today. So, girls, take your stage.
Here you go.
Don't
watch
come
this.
Over here. Come over here. The watch. This is wicked. Here we go.
You ready? Go.
Oh.
This is a bungalow show for Polio with Tom and Dick. We're here to rock and roll. Cause we're gonna have fun, cause we're number one. This is the bungalow show with a candle. With a little bit of this and a little bit of that. So listen up and don't chat. Are you ready to have fun with Bungalow, which is number one? This is the time to just chill out, cause that's what Dick and Dom's all about.
Brilliant, man! Wicked! Do you know what I mean? That was wicked!
Cleo! Yes, very good!
Are you gonna make it?
I know it is.
Jazz.
Right, now we're gonna have a look at the rest of the points, see who's in third, second, and first place. We know who's last, it was Charlie. In third place, with 70 points!
Look at that.
1.2 valve injection, Cleo!
In second place!
With 80 points, Alex!
Well done.
But in first place with 95 points and Shane!
The custard boy!
So now, first firstly, we need to award the third prize, which goes to Cleo.
Clear it.
And what we need to do is go to the door because there's a very special person.
Oh, look, ready? Oh, listen to the music. I can hear the music already.
Is it Christmas?
Is it Christmas?
Can we hear it?
No.
Is it Christmas?
Is it Christmas? Is it Christmas?
No, it's not Christmas. It's not Christmas.
It is Christmas.
Because
Father Christmas is here.
Oh.
Yes.
Santa. Hello. Oh, it's Santa Claus, everybody. He's coming
to
the bungalow.
It's Christmas every day in the bungalow. Okay. And then we've got the third prize for Cleo.
I think his beard's fallen off.
Okay, right. Award the prize, Dom.
What's the prize? Where is it, Santa? Oh. Cleo, where are you, love? Here you go. Say thank you to Santa. Give him a hug. Oh, isn't that sweet?
You've won nose hair clippers and an adapter. And in second place, it was Alex. Come on,
Alex.
Santa Claus, bring out the prize for Alex.
Santa,
one of those.
Discovering mosaics.
What you
wanted to do, wasn't it?
That's really
sit down on a Sunday afternoon and make a mosaic cup.
Well done, Alex. But in first place, the custard boy himself. Here he is. He's still in custard, embedded in there with it all over his ears.
He deserves it, man.
Say thank you, Santa.
Oh, there we go. We're going to put this on here so you don't get it covered in custard.
Well done.
That's it. You can stroke it. Stroke it. It's yours.
Would you like
to stroke it? You can't because it's not yours. There you go. Well done, Shay.
Hey, you've beaten the bungalow heads. Give yourself a cheer. Well done.
Fantastic.
Ready and waiting. Let's go over back over to the sofa for a little sit down. Oh, we'll bring you over. Come on then. For the last time, let's walk him over.
Come on then.
Let's just have a quick look in the toilet because Charlie's there. Look. Charlie's there.
He's looking
getting ready. Look, he's all he's nervous. He's getting a bit, at least he's out of the bee costume. He's not buzzing
he's
anymore.
He's looking a bit sheepish, even though he's
you,
a sheep.
You stand there. No, come back.
Where are you going?
We're talking to you.
What are you doing?
We've not finished yet. You can't go home. I know you want to go home, but you can't yet. What's been your favourite part of the show, guys?
When we had to kick us.
Yeah. Well, that's
us,
Shay. Shay, what's been your favourite moment of the show?
Same.
Being covered in custard. Oh, fantastic.
Give him one last blast of custard, mate, since he's the winner. Go on. Okay.
Since you're the winner, you get one last blast of custard.
There you go. Now over to the Gunjing Charlie. 3, 2, 1, Gunjing! Winner! Thank you, Dickie, nominee Bungalow for another weekend. Hope you've enjoyed it. We've had such a great time.